Hey folks, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com, continuing my tour of my Lego parts. This time, I am taking a little detour from the system-related stuff, the brick-based stuff, to come over here and take a look at some of the large action figure-related stuff in a completely separate area. So let's just get started. I'll probably get through half of this in this video and then continue on in the next video. I'm just gonna start opening up stuff and letting you see what I got. So up here, I put all of my Hero Factory specific heads. I believe these are all Hero Factory specific. All stuff that's related to, yeah, just the more recent, large action figure stuff. Just a collection of stuff that I've got as a result of doing the reviews and stuff. This isn't all of them. Some stuff I do put into a different area. I have a couple of different areas. I think this may not include all of the 1.0 stuff. Looks like some of it is in here, but not all of it. Here's the next level down. And starting here, you're seeing all of the large action figure recent heads, the ones that have been used in the Hero Factory series. Including Glitorian heads that I had from before Hero Factory began. And it's just all that stuff, including the 2.0 series ones and the most recent series ones. I'm not gonna shuffle this all the way around because I've got my Hero Cores in here also, and a lot of those have the codes on them, and a lot of viewers like to steal my codes, which is really uncool, but you can see what's there. And then this is all just hands. And this includes, I believe this is going to include some of the older style hands, or does it? Nope, this is, forgot, this does not include the older style hands with the four fingers in total. These are all just five-fingered hands. Let's move on to the next level down here. Okay, this is all feet. It's all your Hero Factory, Chima, buildable, chi level, also the Marvel action figure, all there. Feet from the more recent series. This is where I started getting into some mixed armor and add-on kind of stuff. I grouped several different types of things together here. Basically, these pieces and these pieces and these pieces are all here. Also got some of these, but just separating things out a little bit. These kind of different non-standard things that can be used as armor, although, these are obviously intended originally to be hands, but I use them as armor whenever I can. Different colors also. Next, did I skip one? No, I did not skip one. These are armor add-ons. So accessories and stuff that mostly attach with the double pin attachment style. Although I also threw these in there, just kind of grouped them together. I just consider all of these to be armor add-ons, things that you directly add on to armor or that can be used directly or pretty close. Even if these little things, all that kind of stuff goes in there. Big mix of stuff. Some things that just use one pin on one side, still it's all. I personally consider all of that to be related. Next, we've got more armor add-ons, and these are the ones that fit on corners of stuff and more armor-like, even though there are accessories that add on to them. And you can see I did include the Chima and superheroes action figure stuff. Mostly three different types of parts are included in here in different colors and such. So that's how I do those. Here we have, taking that out, here we're just looking at the extra wide armor pieces. They're all exactly the same piece, just in different colors. And then this bag here, I have printed pieces. So I separated those out. Obviously not the wide armor pieces, but just anything that's printed, that's a regular style of armor piece I put together in this bag. A lot of that is 3.0 stuff and some 2.0 stuff, and just a kind of a mix. Here, these are all the short, three long armor pieces, all separated out. Lots and lots and lots of them. I have very few things that are built right now. Let's see, one, two. Looks like I only have two Hero Factory. No, I have three Hero Factory style figures that are built right now. So almost all of my entire inventory of parts are in these drawers now. Here comes the big one. Other armor stuff, armor pieces, leg and arm armor pieces that are not three wide. They're longer than three wide, but they are not the extra thick. So not these, but longer than these, not including body armor, not including chest armor. This is a big, major thing of lots of stuff. Most of these, again, are just from getting the figures to review, but I do have some stuff that I've gotten from BrickLink in here, including extras of these, because they didn't come in many different sets. And finally, down here at the bottom, so you can see just how tall that stack is in there. Finally, at the bottom, we get the largest armor pieces, and these are from here to here. All the different styles are in here, and it's just a mix of them. A few of these were recolored, but most of them are original colors. Just a mix of stuff, including printed ones. I did choose to put printed stuff of this size in here, just the way that my brain works, that organization works better, rather than putting all printed pieces together. It's just kind of took priority with the size here. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is close this drawer and take you all the way back up to the top, and then over to the side. This is a big bin of body pieces, of torso bone pieces, not including the small ones, not including the XT4 size ones. So we get the extra large, extra long ones here, and you get the pretty normal ones with the wide shoulders. And somewhere in here, you'll find ones also that are with the narrow shoulders, like so. So all those are in there, and a few colors, but mostly black. Closing that one, coming down to the next level. These are what I consider to be special bone pieces, which include the small XT4 torsos. These that have the same connection on both sides. The super short bones, the super, super short bones, and the friction adders. And some of these strange alternate adapters are also included in here. Separated all that stuff out, so it's easier to find them. Quite a collection of these. Got some of those yellow ones in there too, that's cool. And then the next one down, this one is most normal bones, not including a very common, I'll show you in the next one, the ones that are not included here, but normal length bones that are usually used for legs and arms, not including the most common ones, which are here. So this container contains these in black and dark bluish gray. So a total of four things. It's two shapes in only two colors. I separated them out because they're so common and there's so many of them that it was nice to be able to go through bone pieces that are not just those separately here. So I separated these out for the sake of being able to get to these more easily. And there's just so many of these, you know, it's instant to just grab exactly what you want. And, you know, sometimes if I do things that are long, have tails and stuff like that, I'll just grab a whole bunch of these. And sometimes when I take stuff apart, I'll leave some of them still connected together so I can more easily build more stuff in the future. This is an underused drawer. I'm kind of leaving extra space. You know, this could be converted. It's a tall drawer. This could easily be converted into two of these short ones. These bins are interchangeable. So that's probably eventually what I'll do, but I don't have an extra small drawer for now. So you can see what's in here. Just a few things. These pieces, these old pieces, and these pieces just separated out because they didn't really go into the categories of other stuff. Here, oh, this should not be in here. So occasionally you'll see stuff that is not fully sorted or not fully separated out just yet, but this is a real menagerie of all sorts of strange shaped things, mostly Hero Factory specific stuff that just hasn't, stuff that I don't use a lot, and it's just weird shaped, odd, strange stuff. These and that shouldn't even be in there. That's a system part. Yeah, these have been in here since before I started doing more system stuff, so I'll have to take those out. But you can pretty much see the different types of things that are in here right from the start. Mix it up a little bit, and it does include the 2.0 visors or goggle bits just randomly. Might even separate these out, put them in with system stuff or other. I don't know. It's just a very strange bin. This one is definitely the most expensive bin that I have because it has all of my remaining Bionicle heads and also some other heads. So these faces, and these are your Bionicle head pieces that go underneath. Lots of different ones there, different colors. I've really thinned these down over the past couple of years. I've sold probably this bin worth of heads and masks and still have these left over. These are just the ones that are most likely to be used again, but as time goes by, the chances of me using these become more and more and more and more slim. Every time I use a Bionicle headpiece or a Bionicle part, get way too many commenters that are just, you know, bio trolls that come through and say, ah, yes, Bionicle, that is a Bionicle. Bionicle is great. Down with Hero Factory forever, which is just, you know, it's just annoying. Just really brings things down for absolutely no reason. You know, folks that don't respect different people's likes and desires. So more of this stuff will go away, especially now that we found out that the next generation of Hero Factory stuff is going to move to minifig-sized or slightly larger than minifig-sized heroes. So most of this stuff will no longer apply. We still have some mechs and larger-sized enemies, but a lot of this stuff is going to end up going away. And you know, there is a mix in here of some Hero Factory stuff, obviously. But mostly Bionicle stuff left over. So much stuff. There's some rare stuff in here, some odd stuff. I think I still have some copper. I think I have one of each copper mask from Bionicle, the old ones, in here somewhere. You may have seen them by now. Just tons of stuff. So much. It's crazy. This is actually gold. Kind of looks a little bit copper, but it's actually gold. That's one of the newer ones. But anyway, yeah, lots of that. Oh, here we go. Here's a copper one. That's a genuine copper one. I believe that was from Billund. Exclusive that you could only get at Legoland. Got it on eBay, of course. I think I have a couple of these and then one of the other. But yeah, lots of stuff. Unfortunately, so much of which is not going to be used again in the future. So I'm going to move over to the third column here, and I will not finish this column, but I will show you some stuff that's here. So feet, Bionicle style feet. The ones that remain. This is one bin of them, the larger ones. Larger ones. This is a bag. I've sold off probably that many worth of these also. Of claws. The large claws and the small claws. That's all that's in there. And then the rest of the feet, the Bionicle style feet, are here, and you can pretty much see all the different types that are included here right from the top. And yeah, these are just smaller things that are still going to be used well into the future, even as a Hero Factory switches over. These are still going to be used for guides and mechs, definitely for mechs. Then got this drawer here are the old style hands with four fingers in total in a bag, separated out. These break easily, you have to be careful with them. And then all these types of pieces go together. This includes new and old, just a wide variety, lots of the transparent ones, got some of the less common colors, got some good stuff in here. Look at this, is the pearl gunmetal kind of color. These different from these, new and old. There's some other rarer stuff. Got some of these also, different colors. I've also reduced my numbers of these quite a bit. Again, probably sold off this many of these types of parts. Especially stuff like this, of which I had just probably hundreds of these extra. Just don't use them that much anymore. This is what remains of those types of parts. And this is the last one. No, I'm going to go through this drawer and then one more. And then stop this video because it's getting long enough. 1.0 stuff. Ben 10 stuff. Chima heads. And superhero heads. Superhero specific stuff. Just a mix of mostly non-Hero Factory or non-current Hero Factory stuff, including the 1.0 Hero Factory stuff that mostly isn't usable anymore. So there you go. Oh, also includes... Oh, hey, that doesn't go in there. Well, yeah, it kind of does. 1.0 stuff. I try not to use those because they break easily. And these claw pieces are here. And the last one I'm going to show you is this bin, which gets used a lot. Don't really need to see this, but this is all small miscellaneous special stuff. Really needs to be split up into more drawers. Maybe I'll use some of that extra space to my right to split these apart, because you've got the different styles of barbs and just all sorts of stuff that it's just, I mean, started out as stuff from Hero Factory, yeah, from Hero Factory in particular, and it's just grown. Every time I get new weird stuff, this is glow in the dark. These T pieces that I use quite a lot, all the Flickfire missile bases, which I've started, you know, getting lots of those even before I knew what a Flickfire missile was. Got these even in silver. Have some all my three long bars are in here, as well as most of the four long bars included in here. I want to separate those out eventually. The only ones that are not included here are the glow in the dark and transparent ones. All the Exo Force arms are included in here. Some torsos from the Bionicle minifigs, even though I've still got two sets of Bionicle minifigs that are mostly together. This gets used a lot. Droid arms, skeleton arms. You can see a lot of this stuff that really needs to be moved over to system bins. But for now, it's all together, including stuff like these are really uncommon, transparent protective end pieces. These pieces went in here because they're related to another piece that's already in here, and yeah, related to these. So this is a little bit of a mess, but that does it for this one. That does it for now. So you've gone through about half of my bins here that are related to the large action figure stuff. So in the next video, I'll probably go ahead and finish off the rest, Technic stuff and Bionicle stuff. Ooh, there's also more of these on the other side. Older Bionicle stuff and larger Bionicle pieces that I'm really not using a lot, not including an entire box of stuff that I've already separated out again to do another sell-off of parts. So lots more to come, but that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed that sneak peek into my world and how I organize more of my parts. I've got a lot more of these to go. So I'm actually going to get to cleaning up some stuff, putting away some old parts now, and then get to building some more stuff. So thanks for watching. I hope you'll stay tuned for more. Bye for now.